The next essential Teams feature I want you to know about is the filing structure available to you in Microsoft Teams. When you're filing your files normally, think about how many folders deep you need to go. You have that main folder, subfolder of subfolder, and so on and so on. Well, now I'm going to get you to think of the main folder as the team. The subfolders is like your channels, your topics, and then any subfolders of that, we can actually, rather than having subfolders for everything, we can create what's called columns or metadata within our filing system within the Teams channel. So I'm in the human resources team, in the performance management channel, and in the files area of that channel. And I have a few files going on in here, and I want to show you how to add columns and create this metadata that we're talking about. So you can see that it looks pretty obvious how you're going to add a column. We're going to just click on that add column button. It's going to tell us what kind of columns we can add. Let's start by adding in a date and time column. So the column I'm going to create for a date and time is a renewal date column so that I know when I need to renew these documents. I don't need a time on it. And friendly format means it would show as in today or tomorrow, that kind of format. And I'd like it to show the actual date. Default value, I could have it show today's date every time I add a file in, but that doesn't make sense for what I'm doing here. So I'm not going to worry about a default value. And I'm just going to click on save. Okay, I'm going to add a couple more columns and then we're going to fill in this information beside these files. So keep in mind, the columns may not pertain to every single file, but they pertain to the bulk of them. Let's add a column that's a choice column. Let's define what kind of files we have, like are they agreements, are they forms, are they letters, you know, what kind of files are these? So I'll call my column type of document, and the choices of what I'm going to rename. And then with the choice column, you can choose whether you want to have people add values manually. The only danger with that might be the consistency. So you decide if that makes sense. And again, you can have a default value. So one of the values you put in, if it mostly is letters you're having in here, that can be the default, but people could change it. I'm going to leave that empty. And there are more options. And so the options in this case, so the options could be different based on the type of column you're choosing. The display choice I'm going to keep is the drop-down menu, whereas I could change it to radio buttons instead. Do I want to be able to pick more than one answer for my column? In this case, no. And do I require that this column contains information? So that's kind of a good way of making sure that everybody fills in this column all the time. I'm going to say no to that. And do I want to enforce unique values? So in this case, it would make no sense to have unique values. It's going to be repeated values here. But if it was maybe an ID number or something like that, I might want to have unique values. So let's save this. Okay, and one more column. And this one we'll add in as a person. So it says it's showing here, use names of people or groups from your organization. So it's not going to let you type in any name. So I can say that this column is about who can approve the documents. Let's just save that. Okay, so we have a few columns of information that is adding to the columns here. So one way to add information to our columns is to click on a particular line that has a file and then go to the eye, this little circle with an eye in it, that's information or details. So it's kind of giving me an example of what's in the file. It's also telling me who has access to this file, and I'm looking for renewal date and type of document. So further down, I see renewal date, type of document, and approver. So let's say renewal date, choose a date here, type of document, we'll say that's an agreement as we see from the name of it, and the approver, I'll type in my own name. Okay, and if I look further down, it gives me some other information about the activity of this particular file, but that's it. There's no save button, it just updated the columns for me, so I'm gonna close out of there. Now, if I want to do a whole bunch at a time, it might be too slow to go to this little details pane. So that's really handy if you're kind of just doing one or two at a time. If I'm doing all of them at the same time, it's better for me to go to where it says edit in grid view at the top here. So let's choose that. And I already have an agreement on this one, so I'm just going to grab this and choose the same value for the second one. And let's put a different date on this one. And we'll say for myself, I'll say I'm doing most of the approving. Okay, let's just fill in a few of these. This looks like it's a form. Yeah, and so you see how this is quite handy to have this little pull down, isn't it? The letter, but very fast to fill in. So just in the sake of time here, I'll just copy some of these things. All right, And now once you're done editing, you want to go to exit grid view. Okay, and so now I can go to type a document. I can click there, I can group. So now I'm seeing it kind of like folders, but they're open folders now, right? I can turn that grouping off. You see that I have a sort option there. Let's do the filter option. I only want to see the forms and apply. All right, so see how this can be a better alternative than folders? You can still have folders and use this with the folders. Just keep in mind, if you have a folder, this data that I put on these files is not available to be put onto a folder. So if I had a folder name here, I could not add in a renewal date or type a document. That would not work for a folder. Let's clear our filters. Okay, so give that a try.